If you are trying to catch the public's attention by creating a business that is built from ecological resources, can you give us some advice to create a new business that will find different ways to manage recycled paper or recycled materials?
Very good question related to recycled paper. Today, when we recycle paper, we contaminate a lot of water with the ink. So we have the fibers again, but we have the ink in the water. So we're trying to do good, but we're doing bad. It's like with me, my factory. I wanted to have a biodegradable soap, but then I used palm oil and I was destroying the habitat of orangutan. So we have to think through when we want to do something good, is it really good all the way? Or are we tolerating collateral damage, unintended consequences? We can't do that. So there's a new technology. It's called the vortex. And the vortex is like a swirling movement that you will see anytime you flush the toilet. Right? Immediately it starts turning around. Well, that force, that centrifugal force, when you do it without water, when you have shredded paper, will separate the ink from the paper. I don't need water anymore. That's an innovation. That's something that can be implemented. But you know what happens? The technology is still very young. And when technologies are young, you can't do it in a big scale. You can do it small scale. And that's where you guys come in. Start small. Grow big.
What country do you think will be the next great power and why?
I think we will not have countries anymore as great powers. Countries were invented by the French aristocrats over 300 years ago. Time is over to think like French aristocrats. We got to think like people who live in a culture, in a community, and that's going to be the driving force. I think the moment that we think in communities, that we think in societies where we share common beliefs and common interests and where we can jointly benefit from that wealth of biodiversity that we have received, I think we'll make big changes right there. I'm today doing very advanced initiatives in a little country like Bhutan, where we have an economy where every single economic decision is compared with one parameter: does it make people happy? And if it doesn't make people happier, we don't do it. Even if we make money. Now, that is one logic. Then we're working on a small island in Spain. Spain has a huge crisis today. It's one of the only islands where today, it's called El Hierro, where there is job generation, where there is immigration, where there is full employment. And people say, that's not possible. Well, that's fine that you think it's not possible. Maybe you should first change your mind. And so I think instead of trying to look at China or India or Brazil or South Africa or America or Germany, let's put them to the side. 90% of the citizens in the world live in communities and love the community where they live in. And they want to have a future in that community. So why worry about those big guys? Let's just do things good where we are.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pauly.
Hi, we are here with Alicia and we are going to ask some questions. Hi, Alicia, where are you from?
Hello, I'm from Poland, from Europe. And if you don't know where is Poland, perhaps you know where is Germany. So Poland and Germany, they're like neighbors.
What did you know about Manizales before you came?
Couple of months before, I met some Colombian friends, and they are from Manizales. So I spent with them like 3 months or something like this. So they were telling me about Manizales, about the people, about the nature, the landscape. So I had, let's say, more or less the idea what Manizales looks like and how are the people. But they told me that they're not going to tell me everything about Manizales. They told me that they have to go there and to see everything. So it was kind of, you know, mystery for me to discover the Manizales.
What are you going to be doing this year in the school?
First of all, I'm going to have with you some conversational English classes. So no grammar, no writing, but speaking, socializing, interacting. I hope having some games and nice discussions, presentations, something like this.
Thank you, Alicia, and welcome to our school.
Thanks a lot for the interview and see you during the classes. I hope so.
Hi, we are in our English class and we are going to talk about the first project we had. This is about a presentation or a building or a most important monument in the world. Okay, she's gonna talk about the presentation, how to do and what we have to use it.
Okay, good morning. The instructions for the presentation were to use the how-to box that about describing architecture monuments. And we have to use superlatives and fronting grammatics and like the most important things about the history of those monuments. Some examples of these monuments were the tower, the Eiffel Tower, and the Pyram of the Sun, and we have the other ones.
The Egyptian pyramids are ancient pyramids, shaped masonry structures located in Egypt. They are 1,038 pyramids discovered in Egypt as 2008. Most were built of tombs for the country's pharaohs and their consorts during all a Middle Kingdom periods.
The earliest known Egyptian pyramids are found at Sahara, northwest of Memphis. The pyramid and its surrounding complex were designed by the architect Imhotep and are generally considered to be world's oldest monument structure constructs of Desert Mansory.
Hi, this is the Empire State Building.
The Empire State is located in New York City and the intersection of 5th Avenue and West 34th Street.
The Americans built the Empire State because they need an economic build.
The King Kong movie was filmed on the top of the Empire State.
Now we are preparing our second project. It is about a charismatic person.
In this class we are doing the internet search about the charismatic person. We have to do a PowerPoint presentation with minimum 10 slides and we have to add the answer of the question, if you were the most powerful leader of the world, what would you do to help the society?
Minds and super brain that are people that have special abilities to, for example, in drawing, painting, playing music, and other things. Okay, a phenomenon in a reality show that they pretend to things to the people that have like special abilities and other things. And they look for them, and Chris Angel is like a phenomenon for that show.
Okay. I'm gonna ask you to hold the bottom of, now there's nothing around, right? Is this fair? Hold the corners and hold them right down to the ground there. Hold them right down to the ground, just like that. I'm gonna catch some wind there. See that? See how we're getting some wind like that? We can see completely flat, but we're gonna get some wind. Since you like that so much, I'm going to do it one more time. Can I bother you both to hold on to a corner? We're going to create a little bit of a sail here. Create a sail, get some air, get some wind to happen. Get the air underneath there, just like so. Now watch. I want you to watch this very, very carefully, okay? I'm just going to come straight up and down. Now I'm going to run to the water.
In the name of the Father, and in the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Take, O Lord, I receive my entire liberty, my memory, my understanding, and my whole will. All that I am and all that I possess, you have given in me. I surrender all to you to be disposed of according to your will. Give me only your love and your grace. With this, I will be rich enough and will desire nothing more. Amen. In the name of the Father, and in the Son, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Buenos días, hoy nos encontramos con el Dr. Wilson Botero, es el auditor externo que nos visitó esta semana en el colegio y le vamos a hacer algunas preguntas. Dr. Wilson, ¿cómo encontró el colegio?
A partir de la auditoría pudimos identificar una serie de hallazgos, que es como se denomina en términos de auditoría, aspectos positivos o relevantes, y también identificamos aspectos por mejorar. Algunos de los aspectos positivos que se pudo evidenciar en la auditoría es pues el alto nivel académico que maneja el colegio, por los resultados de las pruebas ICFES, por el posicionamiento que tiene el colegio frente a los demás de la ciudad, ¿sí? Es el primer lugar que ocupa, me parece muy meritorio. Como aspectos positivos vemos también la proyección que está haciendo el colegio hacia la comunidad, la proyección hacia el eje cafetero, esos proyectos de regionalización. Les contaría también que hay algunas oportunidades de mejora. O sea, siempre las organizaciones, por muy buenas que sean, tienen posibilidades de mejorar. Por ejemplo, en el manejo de algunos formatos que se puedan fusionar y reducir el uso de papel, ¿sí? Trabajando dos tipos de información a veces en un solo documento. Por ejemplo, en el caso de las compras, por mejorar también esos indicadores de gestión o más bien los niveles de aceptación que tienen definidos a los indicadores de gestión. En estos momentos son muy exigentes, son muy rigurosos, podrían hacer un poco más laxo ese nivel de aceptación de los indicadores que se tienen y demostrar un mayor cumplimiento. Pero un aspecto que también vale la pena destacar es el alto nivel de acciones de mejora que tiene el colegio, porque vemos que conocen la pedagogía ignaciana, que de alguna manera ayudan a controlar de que los profesores cumplan con lo que está planificado, que sigan los procesos, en fin. Entonces me parece excelente que esa cultura de la calidad se viva en toda la comunidad educativa. Una invitación a todos es, primero, a los estudiantes a que sigan preocupados porque las cosas salgan bien en su colegio, pero ustedes como estudiantes también, bueno, felicitaciones, porque definitivamente son muchas las cosas buenas que vemos en el Colegio San Luis Gonzaga.
Bueno, muchas gracias, y para terminar, un mensaje para todos los estudiantes.
Un mensaje: que sigan amando y cuidando a su colegio, hagan todo lo que sea necesario para mantener ese primer lugar que tiene hoy el colegio en la ciudad, mantener ese nivel muy superior en las pruebas ICFES, y eso básicamente se logra haciendo las cosas con cariño.
Bueno, muchas gracias.
Buenos días, mi nombre es Sandra Liliana García, coordinadora de salud ocupacional. El Colegio San Luis Gonzaga se unió a la campaña nacional del plan de emergencias y el plan de evacuación con el firme propósito de continuar con una cultura de prevención en este sentido. Aunque se presentaron algunas debilidades en el proceso de evacuación, como incumplimiento en las normas impartidas para el desplazamiento y demora en la evacuación, queremos felicitar a toda la comunidad educativa porque este proceso de prevención se fortalece cada vez más. Los invitamos para que sigamos conservando esta cultura y para que seamos distribuidores de esta buena experiencia. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much for tuning in, and have a good day.